we have come to Shamogo University because a couple of weeks ago, we saw in the papers a very, very concerning disturbing story. And of course, on social networks, it's been all over the place. About lecturers, not just in Shamogo, lecturers all over universities in Uganda, asking for sexual favors from students and for marks. And so today we have come to ask, what is happening? What is going on? Is it the lecturer? Is it the student? Who the student is too dumb to perform and they just decide to give the
something for something?
Is it a case of morality here? Or is it a case of actually failure of our education system to enable students pass? Today the students have their say. And of course, if you're at home, ngana we gara kutesa kumulama kuno, tuja kwa konda during this show. I'll probably ask, has anyone here got
okay, you might
most of the victims are ladies. Have you ever been approached by a lecturer asking for you know, such favors to get better?
I've not been approached by one, but at least I have a friend who has been approached. She lost her papers, she passed her coursework and her exam as well. But the lecturer, I think the paper got lost. But the lecturer was just, I don't know what was the issue with him. He was only telling her, come to my home on Sunday, you will do the test again. Then after the year, he tells him, no, don't come. Let us meet in such and such a place, just first take coffee. All that story for
about coffee.
Yeah, it was just
that was her coursework.
But is there some instance that a girl herself reaches the lecturer because this is an
issue. It is not possible.
Girls, are there times when you have approached or had lecturers? Or do you have girls who have approached lecturers?
No, I've not heard of anyone. But I think it's possible because I'm looking at a situation where someone is very desperate. Someone needs to graduate, and they're like, okay, if I can't get the marks, maybe I can offer you myself, and you give me the marks. I think it's a possibility.
Offering yourself
for
some part of the body.
I also agree with her verdict because at the beginning of the same, also our lecturers told, especially one day girls, that you girls, we know you. You come here, you start lousing around as the examination session approaches. You come to offer yourselves to us that we should give you marks. He told them to stand one that they will not accept such.
And Akashaba, do you remember them, Akashaba? Say, once you come with your allowance, your body and approach me.
As in when you are saying a guy.
Yeah.
Because she's a lady.
So do boys approach female lecturers?
To offer what?
No, female lecturers approach us.
No! As in, they can say, man, give me some marks, then I give you three marks. As in, when you see the students, he has really failed.
Okay, let's have one person speak at a time.
You are talking about money.
Some female lecturers, they may see, as in, some guys, as in, have failed. Because they are pleading, what? So, there was lecturers, as in, female lecturers, they may say, bring money.
Of course, have you heard of it or just assuming? You've had people go through that?
Of course, those situations are there. They are there and they're like, bring money, I give you 3 months.
Okay.
What I want to say is a boy, actually not a boy, a man at the university, because everybody at the university is a man. And a woman. If a man approached a female lecturer, just as I know of a certain situation, it is not bad. Some of these lecturers are our age mates. Maybe you are looking for a wife to marry, and she's a lecturer. That one has no harm. But I don't think a female lecturer can approach a student. But in most cases, we have tried to approach female lecturers. Even myself, I would try if I saw some qualities of a good woman. That is very possible.
Would you approach for the case of a relationship or for marks? Because we are looking at, of course anyone can marry anyone, but we are looking at you approaching her something for something, marks, as you also provide some services.
I wouldn't approach a lecturer for marks because I don't believe in sexually transmitted Max. But I would approach her for another reason. Another reason like sexual pleasure, marriage, or something. If she qualifies anyway, and if she sees me that I also qualify, that is possible. But Max, no.
But we are looking at the case where you need your Max. Brain is actually the one that will take you, will give you that degree. Yeah. Not because you had a relationship with the teacher. And so that's what we are looking at now. Yes.
Okay, I for one have never heard of a situation where a male student approaches a female lecturer. But on several occasions discussed with female students, but in their words, it's like for them, they are willing in most cases. Of course, they also people and they have feelings like any other person. You know, some even go ahead and say, I'm willing to do whatever I can to do what to make sure I pass. And of course, some of them are not serious with the books, and at the end of it, they try their level best to do a lecture as they do, falling in love with them so as to secure to get marks.
Yes.
That's what they do. But
you can't attach that to feelings, because you've not done out it like, I want the lecturer, I have feelings for the lecturer, you're just doing it to get marks. Mm. So you can't say the girls have feelings, that's why they're going to approach a lecturer. Mm. They're just desperate and need to pass.
What is the explanation girls are given for sleeping, you know, for doing such a thing?
The girls that definitely want to graduate and leave school. So like, they either give in if the lecturer is not, at times they imagine they come, they're supposed to pay a certain amount and then give them marks.
Mm.
But even the lecturer this time is also not willing. He wants to get the money. He wants actually to explain.
Just give me stuff.
So like some girls maybe accept because she wants to graduate, maybe she has more than enough retake, she can come back here and those things.
Okay.
Let me also make something. I just imagine how a student tells a lecturer that give me or a lecturer gives tells the student, give me sex, I give you marks. Then, like us who are doing business, I would like to attach a quantity, a numerical figure on that. Mm-hmm. What quantity of sex? What quantity of what?
Max.
Of max. The issue is not max for sex. The issue sometimes it is feelings first of all.
Mm-hmm.
As girls, you know, a girl tries to show her feelings to the lecturer, so that the lecturer is moved, and the process marks are transmitted. To the what? To the student.
Yes.
But the student doesn't first of all go to the lecturer to tell him, I'm giving you sex, give me what? Max. Give me marks.
How do they do it, by the way? How do you approach? Yeah. How do they, how does a lecturer start? Because you said we go for coffee. No, first come Sunday.
In the many cases,
how do they do it?
In many cases, they don't tell you. Yeah. I've been at the university, here at Jambo, getting a diploma. Now I'm doing a degree. But in many cases, lecturers don't start this thing.
It is sometimes
the girls who push it themselves first of all.
Yeah.
And in many cases, it is the girls who are failing. Somebody fails like now quantitative methods, fails the first test, fails the second test, and only fail three times, of course,
retail.
You are supposed to leave the university.
Yes, yes.
Now somebody says, what can I do?
Well, if you're just joining us at home, send us a text on your phone, minibus, and type the word minibus, your comment or suggestion, and send it to 6565. The question is still
sexually
about marks. Yes, sexually transmitted marks. And the minibus has come to Chamoku University. Some a few of the students. What is the? Is this a question of morality? Kids, is it now? Are we comfortable with this? Have the students resorted to say, you know, let me go to university, I'll sleep my way through university with every lecturer and graduate with a second upper or first class degree. That's what we are looking at now. We got an opportunity to speak to Lawrence Madate, who is the PR of Chamoku University. Let's take a look at what he has to say, and when we come back, we'll look at what should we do. Is university any quality now? Is it the quality of the lecturers? Where are the systems of checks and balances? What's this?
It's very unfortunate that we've had cases of lecturers abusing their positions in the sense that some lecturers have been known to ask for either sex or money in exchange for for marks. I noticed that this is an ethical problem because you see, in a number of public universities, this cancer has been growing over time. A representation of the kind of problems we have in the society. You see, of course, no public university can condone this kind of behavior because, one, it goes against the very ethical standards of the lecturer-student relationship. Once you abuse that relationship, you are guilty. And as a university, we always take punitive measures. Once such a scenario comes up, it is not condoned. And the lecturer will definitely lose his job. Of course, they will be given an opportunity to defend themselves. In the various committees, departmental, faculty, and senate. But once they are found guilty, they are normally dropped. Let us borrow a leaf from an example, private universities. In private universities, because there are very few levels, once an allegation is made, the investigation process is fairly quick. The response rate is very fast. So you will not see this kind of behaviors in private universities because the students know and the lecturers know the implications.
A couple of statistics here. Out of the 50 lecturers interviewed in 12 faculties and institutes of Makerere University, 30% said they had been approached by girls who promised sex for marks.
They go direct to those girls.
30%.
The girls approached the lecturers.
52% had ever received sexually explicit text messages, emails, and notes from the girls. 78% complained that the girls were deliberately dressing indecently or exposing their body parts.
Mm-hmm.
40% says girls made unnecessary visits to their offices. And furthermore, lecturers said you wink at them.
So is it a question of you students actually luring teachers or lecturers into giving you marks? Is it
straight?
Exactly.
Okay, explain that to West Street.
No, I'm thinking if I approach a lecturer and he knows his ethics, if he's, I don't know, he's not supposed to allow that. He's supposed to come up and tell me, excuse me, young girl, you're here to study, what you're going to get is what I'm going to give you. But if I offer him and he also allows, then we are both to blame.
Ah, talking of blaming, you're all adults. Of course, not. I don't think there's any child at university. So who, if there's a teacher, a lecturer, and you're all adults, who is to blame in a scenario where you want to have sexually transmitted marks? Who is to blame, entirely to blame?
For me, I think they are both to be blamed, but who is the trouble cause? Mainly, because if it's the girl, then it's the girl to be blamed. If it's the lecturer, I think it's the lecturer to be blamed.
Of course it's the girl.
It's both, not the
initiatives.
But has because it's the girl who approaches.
But
first.
You have a right to act to stop me.
But
you either give me a zero or I go with you.
But you know, some of the people have mercy and may be tempted. You know, God says that if someone begs for as in for a bread, don't give him stone.
Well, we can blame both of them, but of course the degree differs. For example, we cannot really blame a girl all that because this, most of these ladies are relatively young as compared to the lecturers as much as the adults. To me, I really feel that the biggest blame really goes to these lecturers. Mm. If at all one really of 60 years can lure a girl of 23 years to have sex with him, what that mean? It means that he is the father, okay, is like a father to this lady, okay. It's like a grandfather to this lady, and therefore, having sex to this, with this student is like having sex with his grandson,
right.
Granddaughter, yeah. Which is unethical. And besides that, it's an abomination already.
Cross generation.
Yeah.
It's okay.
What is the university doing to stop such situations?
I don't think there is any much awareness. Because I don't think they've not put like maybe a public lecture to come and address us like. if a lecturer approaches you for sex in exchange of marks, you can whistleblow here, oh, this is the procedure you're supposed to use, or this is the person to contact, something like that.
Yeah.
I've not heard it anywhere. Maybe it's being done and some of us are just not aware, but as far as I know, I don't think they've done much.
Then what should be done? What do you think should be done to stop such scenarios from happening?
But from what I've heard, it's like those students who were involved in that stuff of getting marks through giving out their body parts, eh?
Mm.
I hear that they're not going to graduate.
They are not going to graduate.
Yeah,
so does the university have names of kids that have paid money and sex?
Yeah, they should listen.
Some money.
So they were told that they're not going to graduate.
Right.
Yeah. That's not specifically sex, but even other malpractices in the exams. So even those that graduated a long time ago are going to be cancelled because it was shortlisted right from those that were caught and...
I'm not understanding that policy. They let you continue paying tuition, you continue studying and sitting for exams, yet they know you're not going to graduate.
No, for me what I've heard of is that these degrees that have been already graduated and they find out that anywhere, somehow, somewhere, you malpracticed or you did like indulging of exams and stuff, they're going to nullify you.
Your degree.
Yeah, your degree.
Right. Well, at home, if you're just joining us and you probably have a child at university, this is crucial. You're sending your child to school. Are they actually in the lecture room or in the lecturer's
room?
That's what we are looking at.